How's it going, everybody? Hope you guys had a great holiday season. Can't believe it's 2018 already. Just the years fly by so fast. It's unbelievable. So anyway, I want to welcome you guys to my Blu-ray pickups haul. Got about 7 titles or so after this holiday season. Ended up getting the newly released edition of The Breakfast Club, released by Criterion. And this is a film that I've always appreciated, a film that, personally I can relate to, the characters. And let's face it, nobody's perfect. You know, we've done something that we shouldn't have done in school or whatever the case may be. But Criterion gave this one a really great restoration. It's sourced from a 4K digital restoration, so picture quality is absolutely beautiful and definitely worth a pickup. And I like how they went with the original artwork for this one. And it has a number of great supplements as well. Definitely one that you guys should add to your collection. The next film I picked up is The Mountain Between Us with Idris Elba and Kate Winslet, a film that I really enjoyed. And I know this film got trashed in theaters, but I thought it was just one of those edge-of-your-seat thrillers, and I love films where, you know, pretty much takes place in the middle of nowhere, and it's a race to survive, and I liked the performance between Idris and Kate. I thought they had a pretty nice chemistry going overall, and yeah, I recommend this one. You get quite a few special features. Of course, this is a 4K edition, so for 4K standards, the picture quality looked good, but it wasn't, like, excellent. I'll rate it a 4.5 though, but there's just a bit of softness throughout the picture. Some scenes slightly pop, but it's just mainly on the soft side. But overall, I'm giving it a 4.5 because I thought the black lows looked really nice. It looked very natural. But yeah, it comes with a few special features as well. And yeah, definitely worth the check out, man. Idris and Kate really did a great job in this one. So when I was watching The Mountain Between Us, the film kind of reminded me of that other great film from the late 90s called The Edge, which I also ended up picking up with Anthony Hopkins, Alec Baldwin. So between these two films, in my opinion, The Edge is far better. Of course, it's another movie about a plane crashing and it's a race to survive as they get chased down and trying to get eaten alive by a bear. And I heard that the bear that they used for the film The Edge was actually a real bear. So that's pretty cool. So yeah, picture quality-wise for this old Blu-ray release of The Edge is not great. It's just like an old master that they use, so it definitely needs a restoration job. Perhaps 4K release would be perfect. But if you've never seen The Edge, if you're a young teenager, do check it out. It really is a great thriller. My next pickup is a new release by Kino Lorber, a film that I've never seen before, starring the great late great Robin Williams, called Cadillac Man. Also co-stars Tim Robbins. So yeah, I heard mixed things about this film, but I'm a completist. I want to get my complete Robin Williams collection going, so I had to pick this one up. And looking forward to this one. Story-wise, it seems interesting when I was reading the what the film is about on the back. So we'll see. I'll check it out and see what I think of it. The next movie I got is The Woman in Red, starring Gene Wilder and the beautiful Kelly LeBrock, which just got put out on Blu-ray by Kino Lorber. Picture quality-wise, just doesn't look good, I gotta admit. It looks like a up-converted DVD, and even up-converted doesn't look good. It just looks like an old, tired master that they used. So, it's a movie that's definitely not gonna get a restoration job. I don't think it's that popular. But I've always been a fan of Kelly LeBrock, from Weird Science and Hard to Kill, that one film that she did with Steven Seagal. And what sucks is, man, Steven Seagal kind of tarnished her, man. I heard he was very abusive towards her, and she kind of got locked up in this house, in this ranch house, and she just didn't want to deal with society anymore. She just wanted to live her life at the ranch and raise, horses and whatnot. And it's just a shame, she just seems like a wonderful person. But this movie I've always liked. It is kind of a weird, bizarre film. Especially Gilda Radner's role in this. And by the way, right after this film, Gene Wilder and Gilda Radner got married. And unfortunately, she passed away, I believe, in 1988 or 89. But yeah, with this Blu-ray release, you get an audio commentary by a film historian, Jim Hemphill, I guess his name is. You also get the original theatrical trailer. But yeah, Kelly LeBrock just looks absolutely gorgeous in this film. Yeah, check it out if you've never seen it. The next film I got is Christmas in Connecticut, starring Barbara Stanwyck. And yeah, this was a film that I've never seen before. And, I would always see it online that it's on sale or whatever. So I'm like, since it's the holiday season, that I pick it up. And it's actually quite good. These are just type of films. You need the patience for it. But if you appreciate classic cinema, do check it out. And I think you guys will like it. It's perfect for the holiday season. So special feature-wise, you just get a vintage Oscar-winning short called Star Night plus the theatrical trailer. But Barbara Stanwyck, always been a fan of hers, from Double Indemnity to the film Titanic that she did in 1953, with also, I believe, Clifton Webb was in that film. But she's a really, really great actress. Always appreciate her. Every time she's on screen, no matter what the film is, it's like you're glued to your seat. You know, she has that perfect screen presence. And yeah, so that is Christmas in Connecticut. And last but not least, I got Pulp with Michael Caine, released by Arrow Video. And I actually did a full review for this film on my channel, but it was for the DVD edition because I didn't have the Blu-ray on hand. So I got the Blu-ray now. And yeah, picture quality-wise, I'm going to rate this one a 4.5 out of a 5 for the Blu-ray. And this one was sourced from a brand new 2K restoration. And it also contains the same special features that was on the DVD edition. And yeah, this is just one of those forgotten gems from the early 70s, and it also features Elizabeth Scott in her final film appearance because she retired at age 50. And also released by Arrow, part of the Arrow Academy line, is The Apartment, which I also did a full review on my channel, so you can definitely look there for that. And The Apartment, it was just a huge mix-up because that was a limited edition set of only 3,000, and it just got sold really, really fast because it's a one of those great classic films with Jack Lemmon, and it's directed by the one and only Billy Wilder. Highly recommend the film if you can get your hands on it. I believe Amazon UK might still have a few copies, but once you know, people weren't able to get it, the prices just skyrocketed crazy, like really high, somewhere around $100-$150 on eBay. So anyway, guys, that's my latest pickups for this time around for January 2018. Thanks for taking a look, and I'll see you guys soon in my next update. Take care.